Hello and welcome to game 3 with Gaben's Gulle-Grabbar. It's round 3 in the Calmar Blood Bowl League, and today we're up against Skaven, I think it was. The Mordheim City Dominators. I've issued the challenge. Let's see if he'll accept. He messaged me earlier and told me he was ready. So he should probably be accepting my challenge any second now. Because if I said minute, I didn't have enough time to wait. My plan today is to beat the Skaven to bloody pulp, I guess. This really sounds like all my plans, and he did not accept, so probably he's fixing a whole lot of stuff with his team there. As you can see, he is down 100 points there, so he probably has to buy some substitutes. He told me he lost 2 players in the last game. I have 1 injury on my team at the moment, but he has had 2 deaths. That's really unfortunate for him. For me, it's COVID. It's, you know, it's great. It means he'll probably field a bunch of noobs that I can probably kill as well. And yeah, let's see if I can win this game. I actually don't know what I will be talking about if this game doesn't start soon. Maybe I'll need to message him again, because nothing's happening. I think I'll do that. But nothing's going on here. Shall we start? I'm texting him. So far, my Blood Bowl 2 experience has been great, except for the losing part. I've had plenty of fun, even though the dice could be frustrating. Especially when you roll the double down stuff. I hate those. Let's see. I'll issue the challenge again. See what's happening. Is it the right team? Yes, it is the right team. I should not have cancelled that. He's telling me he's trying to start the game. Probably this means the game is somewhat bugged, and that we'll have to restart or something. I challenge you now. He's waiting for me to go online on Steam. So, finally! Petty cash! Petty cash! I get nothing! So, that sucks. Let's see what he's doing. He's making choices. Concede? No. Won't do that. I don't actually know why there's a concession button right there. It's like, nope, I won't even try. I guess probably later in league, when you have one really busted team, you look at them, I can't beat them, and they probably just end me. So that means, no, that I will die. Let's see, I have 10,000 in petty cash. That's enough for just about nothing. So let's just skip it. What is his? He's nothing. He had 3 journeymen. All right, he need to fill out his rooster there. Roster. Is it roster? Rooster? Roster? Rooster. That's the one that goes coo-coo-coo-coo. Rooster, roster. I think it's roster. Yeah, roster. Sorry, not the rooster. It's a roster. That's some nice underwear. Gobbo. Right, let's see here what they feel now. Gaben's Gulle-Grabbar will show no mercy. That's Stormwormin, 2 gutter runners, some, is that clan rats or linemen? I have no idea what they're called in this game. And that's a thrower or firer, another gutter runner, and some linemen. Hopefully, I can beat these guys. And I see I haven't turned off Skype. probably that won't ruin my game or your viewing of the game. That's a giant bell up there, and when we come to Skavens, I've learned that giant bells are probably bad for me. Screaming bell, what it's called in the tabletop strategy game. I will probably defend. My plan is to have him knock himself against my lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He has 11 players and no subs, what I can see. I should have one sub. I think I have 13 players in my team. And let's just get my guys together here. I don't want to make it too easy. And then let's put the blitzes back a little. I think probably you should be here. Or I don't have any subs. Did I have 2 injuries? Or did I just have 12 men and 1 injury? Oh, well, should have counted. Anyway, let's do what we can with what I have. That's probably the best. Anyway, I want my catches on the flanks. And blitzes in the semi-mill. I had 50 seconds! Here's a lineman. Let's put the lineman down there. Like that. And have thrower like this, I guess. And then the last lineman like this as well. It's Eric Cantona. Alright. Confirm that setup. And my opponent is a experienced miniature player. He plays like almost every miniature game I've encountered so far. Well, not really all of them, but all the Games Workshop based. He had been playing Blood Bowl in real life, and he told me he's not the kind of guy that plans out his turn very well. So he'll probably just said that to fool me, so I won't believe him. Why should I trust my opponent, especially when they're damned rats? I won't be fooled, rats. So what I want to do is just smack them down hard. I should, you know, my lineman here will probably take a beating, but afterwards, after that, my blockers should be able to halt his advances and make some beat down upon them, grabbing them by the tail, swinging them around, throwing them away. He has a loner there, a lineman loner. Excellent. I should probably, I guess those are the journeymen. They aren't really part of the team, so they won't be rerolling very much. Hopefully, that's a guy with guard over there, a lineman with guard and loner. And that's a gutter runner with block and dodge. That means it's almost impossible to get that guy down. Let's kick off. There's the square. And here we go. And they get an extra reroll. That's not funny. It means they have one more reroll. And the ball got landed very good for them. They can almost pick it up and then move away. So here we go. The first block. And of course, they knock me on my ass. But my guy's alive, so they stand up and be ready to fight. That's another guy. Ah, so that's where you should put guys with the guard. Straight in the center, so they can assist on both flanks without, you know, locking up guys. Wow, come on now! At least have one not defender down. But I'm lucky, all the guys just took a breather down there. And now they're going to pick up the ball. And is there anything special about the guy? No, not really. And anything special? 1, 2, 3 journeymen. Block, guard, block, nothing. Yes, get into base contact with my blockers. I'd love for that to happen. So if I'm going to put the beat down on anything, I won't put the beat down on the journeyman, because I I don't know. He's going to get the option to recruit them after the game, I guess, but they might not be recruited, so there's no point in injuring them if I can injure anybody else. So right now he's removing tackle zones from me. He's going to block me off from the left flank, and then he's going to his last move. He will move up and grab the ball. I don't know if he's going to make a blitz with his gut runner. I would guess that's a good move for him. He picked up the ball without problem, and he's going to throw it to the gut runner. The gut runner has it, and how far will that gut runner go? He hasn't used a single reroll yet. He downed three guys, picked up the ball, and passed the ball, and catched the pass. So he should probably fail a roll any time now. Like if he moves like that. Yes, that's a safe move. Run, gather runner, run! No, yeah, that's a pretty solid cage. He stands up right next to my guy, but there's a shitload of assists there. So I should probably get these guys up first. And then I should see if there's any point in standing that guy up. I don't really know. He has a pretty solid attacking formation here. If I'm going to attack him, that's a double die for his advantage. But this guy here has one die. If I put the guy over there, like you can't do anything, right? Just get over there. And then I probably can have a two die block. Nice. And I have block and he does not. And I have guys over here, so I should probably just mark this guy there. And tackle. Should probably begin over here. And that doesn't do any difference. So yes, let's throw down the tackle, and like that. Unfortunately, we can't push the ball carrier, but we will follow. So I should probably put the guy over here through, you know, make a chain push on the ball carrier. I will still just have really troublesome dice. If we get over here, will he be able to get around me easily? Well, he'll just promenade straight through here. So this guy will probably have to swing in like this. Like that. And this guy, should I just like this? No, I should have stunned this guy up before. Like that. Then I push him there, and I push him. Should I push him back, or should I push him out? I push him into base contact with one of my guys, and follow up. And now I should stand this guy up. And now I should probably get one of my guys over here. Like that. So I can throw another block. Just one die, that sucks. Get the guy up there and throw the tackle. Come on, block against nothing. Good. And I probably want to put him against ball carrier like that. Nice. And that's a stun, I guess. Yes, at least it was an armor break. So that's all I could do. Let's end my turn. And now, thing is, he can just get up and move, and you know, throw the ball. I have just, I have two guys. I have two guys in base contact with this guy, and lots of tackle zones around him. So he has to, whatever he has to do. I have no idea what it is so far. Well, the throw comes. He's going to get it to another gutter runner. That can then move into range, I guess. They have a they have 9 movement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then I go for it. So if he gets the ball to this guy, I'm in deep trouble. That's dodge. But I don't know if he's a scoring team. I guess he's a scoring team since he's Skaven, and that means that he won't take any blocks unless he has to. That's not good because my guy didn't have block. This time he has to make a reroll, or I will definitely kill his guy. I'm not sad about that. It was a 2 die which forced a reroll. That's pretty good for me. This, however, is probably not pretty good for me. That's a stun, I guess. Yes, it seemed that Cristiano Ronaldo is feigning an injury again. So far, my guys will be able to knock him the shit out, but if he stands his rats up here... no, I probably need to get my blocker here out of my blitzer here, Zlatan Ibrahimsen, out of the way, and then he could stand these guys up to put a whole world of hurt upon him like that, getting him away and then standing firm. No, that was unfortunate. It was real unfortunate. It's a chain push, getting my guys out of base contact. Everything just went well there, except for that my guy survived without any problems. Can they put a smackdown upon me, guys? He's going to move out. Trip him. Come on, you can trip him. Trip it! What are you tripping about? Rats, foil again. And he's probably going to build another cage. The ball carrier just needs to get out of one tackle zone over here. No, right off there, and then move out this way. Nope, he made the pass, and he could score. He could definitely score now. He need to do one go for it, and I tripped him! Good job! You there! I like you! I like you the most! So, now I should get my guy standing, and then I should punish some rat face. Just like that. Get up, soldier. No time to be playing around here. And I should probably get this guy over. Over there, yes. Over there. Here. Does he do anything good here? No, he doesn't. But I don't care. I should be covering the ball. Maybe I should put that guy there then. Now he can just walk in like that and grab the ball. But my plan is to get this guy to pick it up. That's the throw and that's the receiver. Can I just free the receiver here? That would be awesome. I freed the receiver like that, and I will follow like that. Then my receiver should move. What can I do? Just one die block. That's not the best. That's not the best. That's better. Let's throw that down. Not really the best. Let's follow. I know. I'm putting myself into tackle zones. And no, I should move. Can I get that rat away? Get that rat away, rat away. I could probably get that rat away. No. Doesn't work. Put him there. Put some tackle zones upon the ball. And this is dangerous. It's really dangerous. I should probably, you know. That's a 50-50 picking up the reroll. Made it. Get the ball over there. That's a third percentage chance. Can I dodge? Probably. Will be dangerous. Like fuck. Whew! Over there. Give him the ball. Yay! He made it! Run. Now, the rats will get to him. He's not that fast. But at least the ball is far away from me. And now I should just stand and hold my tackle zones. None of his guy. I could have thrown that block because that's a one die block against nothing. And that's my god guy, and he's all isolated. That sucks. Now the pressure's on him. He needs to tackle this guy and dodge out or something. He needs to do some kind of dodge roll to get to my guy. And now he just needs to run over there because he knocked down my blitzer. So his gut runner can run up there and tackle me. And since my strength is really poor, it will be an easy block. Oh, a reroll. And a worse result for me, but still a good result. Still just one guy, free from attacker zone. My guy has 8 movement, 1, 2, 3, 4, well, he's in scoring position. He will score if they don't get to him. He's thinking about it. That's a save move. He's going to block him off. Let's say Gotteron is a strength 2 guy. If he doesn't put any backup there, I am really tempted to just, you know, blitz my guy, go for a 50-50 with a reroll chance, and go for it. That would be awesome. Unless they put some kind of backup there, then I'm kind of screwed. Or I could just, you know, dodge out. That would probably be even better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then I need to do a... Oh, that sucks. He got there. Oh, he had a block as well. Well, I got the ball far from my side. And he fails to pick it up. So I got that going for me, which is nice. And now I'll probably stand some guys up and punch some face. What can I do? You there. If you throw a block there, nothing happens. If you throw a block there, nothing happens. And you, if you throw a block there, you have 2 die. You have 2 die. You have 1 die. Well, because they are in tackle zones, that's why. What about you? Nothing. Oh, I stood him up, that's why. Let's see. What can I do? Nothing is really good. I really need to take one of these dice here to get this guy away. Move it like that, push him out of the way, and follow. Now this guy can get over here. Now I should be able to knock this guy. Or I should knock this guy. Like that, with a blocker. Good, now he can move up. I'm going to put the tackle zone onto that ball. Won't help. That will help a lot. That didn't do much. Fortunately, I have to follow. I didn't mean to free him up. And let's see here. This guy kinda has nothing. And this guy has a block. And this guy has block. Let's go for the blocks. Good. Follow up. Nice punch! Fortunately, that's just a stun, which means I can't push him in out into the open. And you will also go for it, but you will reroll that because I won't accept that shit. That sucked. And follow. Like that. What can you do? You can do nothing. You have no power, no nothing. You'll just stay there. And end my turn. Things went from looking better to looking neutral. I know they could get the ball into my end zone probably in two turns from there. You could just blitz my guy, pick the ball up, make a pass, and this guy is in a scoring position. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, without rerolls. And he freed up the ball. He had block against no block. It was still a risky move. Shouldn't probably have rerolled that attacker down over there. It was a waste of reroll. He gets the ball. He's going to do a handoff. At least there are tackle zones everywhere. If he gets the ball, if he moves here and gets the ball there, moves there, gets, hopefully I should get to intercept or try an interception. I should probably tackle that guy before doing anything else to remove the interception. Because if he gets the ball, he can score in this turn, not in two turns as I had hoped for. So when I said things are looking neutral, I actually meant things are looking really sour. Looking rat's ass poor. And here comes the gutter runner. That's not what he meant to be doing. He should move and then pass. Can my guy intercept from there? Yes, I will attempt that. I failed. He succeeded, and that's a score for him. Blasted freaks. Yes, and now I'm in trouble. I don't want to watch the chilies. I'll probably pause sport to remove those four guys. PRP. I need to think about that. At least I get to see how he's going to defend. And after his defense set up, I can bash some face. I have plenty of time to score. The idea is that it's the old 2-1 grind I'm going for, allowing him to score quickly. Then I can take the remainder of the half to equalize. Then I will be on the offense and I will slow things down, guard the ball, and spend the entire game doing one touchdown, leaving no time for him to score and equalize. That's the plan now, unless he's making a really poor move so that I can wreck him. Right now I can just waltz between him, and of course we haven't injured anything else. There have been no good armor breaks for either team, which is kind of funny because when that determines outcome, things suck. But if we look at their guys, their lineman is having 7 in armor value, mine have 8, so probably they should have at least one guy knocked out if compared straight up. Right, now he has left. So should he move those guys? Probably over there. Yes, now. That looks much better. He's going for the double defense. All the tackle zones everywhere. I'm going to break through in the middle. That's my plan. Let's set up. I'm going to put my blocker with guard over there, like that, and I'm gonna put a guy over there, and that guy over there. I'm going to put my receiver on this flank. And I'm going to put blitz there. And a lineman. Where are we going to put them? Put him over there. You over there. You are not doing anything good. You can stay there. Same for you. You can stay there. You can jump over here. covering the ground. Let's see what's happening now. Yes, this seems fine. Confirm setup. I have no idea if this is the best move. He's going to kick the ball. Whatever Skaven does nowadays. They are firing the ball. It's a high kick. And I get to move this guy to grab the ball. Hopefully he grabs the ball as well. Well, nice. I should probably move him up here, where I can defend him from harm. There. Put him there. Like that. Put the blitzes on his flanks. That's alignment. Now. That's a blitzer with a 2 die. Knock him out. Push him in the middle. Follow. Nice! And yes, it's done. And that's another. He's putting all the journeymen in the middle. it sucks being a journeyman. Follow. And that's another. That's just a stun. Just a stun. Stuns are still good. However, I would prefer to have something more. Now, this means I have plenty of time to knock him pretty bad. Fortunately, I can just put him where my guys can't reach. And 3 knockdowns, 3 stuns. Well, at least I did the armor breaks, but I would have really enjoyed getting the guys out of the field. This is guy with block, and this is a guy without block. So I should probably move my guy. No, I should defend the ball carrier. Like this. I should take my time and defend the ball carriers. I've knocked 3 guys down. That's good enough, as you can say. Like that. That's a solid defense. Yes, he's being really lucky with my arm rolls. Now, this is the cage of all cages. The thing is, well, still down, they're doing an immense job of not allowing me to push through. And that's probably my fault. I put them in the middle without even thinking about leaving space to run through. But the good thing is, my cage will be able to move in any direction, but I will not be able to throw any blocks. And his storm vermin. That's just one storm vermin, right? So I would probably go for the right flank because of his blocking guys over there. My blockers are all here. Should be very exciting to see where I could go. Thing is, pushing up too close to the side. He wants me to go. No, that's just 2 spaces. Where can my thrower go? My thrower can go all the way here. I should probably put my thrower here and then tackle this guy out of the way. Like this. Yes, let's put him there. And this guy. Yes, in the cage competition I am winning. That's correct. This guy should probably be the one who puts an assist over there. And put a blocker here. I don't know if I moved too close to that guy. I probably did. And this guy should put that guy there. It's another blocker. Can you reach that zone. Yes, he can. And let's see this blocker. If I go like that, I get to die. Great. That's what I want to do. I want to get that guy out of here. Nice rolls. Push him over there and follow up. Nice! And still just a stun. Can't any shit. Shit. Alright. That's it. And let's get the rest of the guys over here. Like this. Bogging down everything. And put some guys here. Probably should move all the way up there. Yes, let's do that. And mark some guys over here. Seems nice. So, great. I have 4 knockdowns, 4 armor breaks, so that's good. Unfortunately, no knockouts, no nothing. I really need those knockouts because his rats are greater than my guys. They are great movement. Oh, what is it? Yes, they have great movement, but they're just as agile. So they have speed and stuff. I'd really need for them to die. Otherwise, they are the better team. And just now, right now, I can't injure them properly. And that's my problem. Woohoo! Why are you playing fair now? Kill the bastards! And since I can't count, and I have just the 11 guys for the game, I can't really... what would you call it? I can't really try to foul anybody either. Because then they would just... He's going for it. He's going to put up a block over here, I guess. He made the go for it, and here comes the 2-die block. No, he forgot the blitz for that. He does it with this guy, and of course he gets my guy down. But it's just a knockdown. So he can stand up, and then I can punch back. Unfortunately, I wouldn't really like to punch back with this guy. Because I would love for him to be free to... No, he can't move up that way either, because it's standing a rat over there. So then he could just punch that guy in the face, because I have nothing better to do. I really need to make a dent on the opposing team, because they will destroy me unless I can remove some players from the pitch, field, whatever. That's a sneaky move. It's like he's going for the counterattack already. He should get his guy up. He should have done that before he knocked my ass over here. Because if he failed that thing, he will just have some people chilling out. Here comes the blitz. He makes double rolls, and then he gets my guy knocked down as well. That was unfortunate for me. And that's very lucky for him. That's really unfortunate for me. I have to choose one of them. Like that. I guess it's a guy with blocks, and things come. So that means it's probably fair. Do I have any good blocks? Poor block. Get up. Good block. Good block. Poor block. Get up. And get up. Stand up, soldier. So block. 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 All right. What happens if I do this? I knock him, and And I just push him away, so that's not really good. I will follow up. This guy will have a double knock. I think that's the better option. And of course, I need to do a reroll because that sucked. That was better. Push the guy away, follow. Like that. This guy could move over. No, he can't move for shit. It's really, really crowded here. And I have no good blocks to throw. Well, 2-1, get him! Nice. Push him away. And I guess I should follow. Nice. And yes, it's done. I just can't get these rats off the pitch. It's really hurting my chances to win this. I should move over here. Get this guy in there. And this guy should probably get over here. And for some reason I decided it was a good idea to dodge through that tackle zone. It was my last move anyway, so it didn't hurt that much. I have just 2 turns, and I have just like no chance at all to get the ball down. He's having all the tackle zones, and so far he's been out-blocking me, even though he's a more fragile team, and that sucks like hell. There's my receiver, he's going down. That's really bad, because who should now pick up the ball? Probably a blitzer. Could probably get this blitz into scoring position next turn. Tackling here, throwing a block there. Getting the ball, moving up. No, I won't get him the ball. Well, they should probably move over here as well. I'm in a rough shape! I'm in definitely a rough shape here. I'm in a rough spot. His rats. There's something gnawing on my mind. Fortunately, even his poor results is good for him, because he's putting tackle zones on his guys while removing assists for me. And there's another one. That one was just pure 50-50, and he made it. No, he could blitz this. No, he could blitz this guy into my tackle zones. He made that roll as well. I have no more rerolls. Is he going to throw even more blocks at me? He should probably move his guys over there. Like that, to remove my zones. Block, block. He has a double block. What's this push? He's pushing my guy, and he's removing my thrower even further. Yes, this is really poor. That chain push sucked. And now I get a blitz without tackle zones. Come on, fail. At least it was. I still have the ball, which is good. Now I can't pick my guy, stand my guy up. If he does that. No, he didn't. I thought I could be so lucky to. Alright. What should be blitzing? don't know yet. Probably this guy. Stand this guy up. Stand this guy up. Today. Today. Blitz this guy. Good. Well, unfortunately, he has dodge. So, didn't do anything. So he has to stay there. You go there. And you can follow. No injuries. You have two dice. Come on, get him. He uses dodge again. Push him there. And follow. Danger zone. Now things are looking better. Can I get this guy away? No, I can't. Can I get this guy away? Definitely not. If I put my guy there. That. Can I now? No. Can I now? Yes. Let's do that then. And kick him. Kick him where it hurts. Follow. Like that. And then my blitzer. Could threaten to score. How far can he go? I definitely need to put him where he can score. I can't score from there. Do I have any good blocks here? Not there. Not there. There. If I get that guy, it'd be good. And stay. Nice punch! He's dead! Finally! Something good! Yay! It was one of his good guys as well. And he's still dead. That was sad. He used Apothecary to save one of his leveled up guys and it didn't work. That was actually sad. Let's just push him away. Follow. How far can this guy go? Not far enough. Go like there, and there. 67% chance dodge. No, I won't do that. I need to move. Like that. Let's see. I killed a guy. Finally. I did something right this game. Hopefully. And this will come back to bite me probably. Yay! Double down! He has no rerolls. I'm lucky. Better lucky than good. Like that. Alright. If I get the ball over there.
bones, and he's injured. Now things are looking good. Things are looking much better. If I can just get the ball to my guy as well, like that, things will be fine. Catch. Nope. Well, it was unfortunate that I fumbled the ball there, because I got through, I had everything for the 2-1 grind ready. Unfortunately, my guy rolled a 1 or a 2. So, he's going to defend. Let's see how he's going to field his guys. I will try to break through. I should probably put the double blockers on the side where I have my weak guy. Seems like he wants this guy to die. No, he wants this guy to die. Yes, now I can set up my team. You. And you. Switch places. Yes, you. Switch places, I said. Blocker should move up. Like this, something like that. Yes, confirm setup. What will happen on the kickoff? If I go for the win, which I should do, because I'm 11-9, I definitely need not to have him have another more have more rerolls than me. Okay, let's see. Let's throw a block here. Like that. I have block, he doesn't. Knock him down. Yes, to knock him down. Like that. Push him over there. And follow. And knocky knocky. Good. And follow. No, stay. And that's nice. That's a KO. Good job. Now they're falling into it. They're really putting the hat on this on the Ratman. That's what I want from this game. So now my blitzer is moving up the field. Together with this guy. Defending him. No, I won't do a double go for it. I'm going to put him over there. Like that. And then I'm going to use these guys to cover the ball. Probably like that. And like this. And let's see, can you pick it up? Yes! With a reroll he can! that's great. Now, this guy, I can probably put my guy here. I will not try to injure his guys. And this guy could stand over here, just to make it harder for him to knock my guys over. I should definitely be able to score here. This is my game. This is what I've been waiting for. I have put together a quite bashy human team. At least I have tried to establish the bashiness in my team by having the maximum number of blockers, by favoring as many blocks as possible. And here comes a block against me. That's a guy with block against another guy with block, and he gets him knocked down. What's his problem? He's easily injured. So far, my guys are alive and well. He need to put a tackle zone onto these guys so that my thrower can't get away. So marking my receiver. I think too hard. He's double marking my receiver and my blitzer. Now things are getting serious over there. And no, he shouldn't go for it. That seems better. He's definitely trying to defend against my onslaught here. I still need to score quickly. It's definitely pushing my guys. That guy sucks at tackling. So you should stand up. You should move over here. You should bring your friends. Like this guy. Things are scary here. I really need to get that guy away. Oh, this guy is free. He can move up there. Catch some stuff in. And if I get my guys free, I will blitz the shit out of them over there. So let's... That didn't work. That did work. Let's try it. Can I push him? No, he didn't get free though. So, should I stay or should I go? Doesn't matter, let's follow. Just put tackle zones on them then. And... two dice against that. So here, I have one die. Alright, let's put the double die. And it worked pretty well. And... follow. That's a die with a block. Put him over there and follow. I should probably put him there. I don't know. Here we have one die, one die, one die, and my guy has block. So probably knocking this guy, that guy, this guy. Okay, well, we both on block, but I am lucky. Better lucky than good. And stay. Move! Hit it! Hit it! Force him to mark my guy over there. Oh, nice, and he's doing some stuff. Good, good, good. Real good. Still going for the 2-1 grind. He's deciding to put a wall of hurt on my guys. Probably good. That's correct. I am lucky. I'm definitely lucky. My blitzers do have 8 in armor value. It's not very much. It's more than his guy, so. That's unfortunate for him. He has to reroll. And he can't reroll because that's a loner! Poof! Turnover! Stun! Damn loners! So. He will probably move over here. I should put guys there and there. Where do I put him? Where should I put him? There. So one guy behind. There. Like that. That. Then I should stand him up to remove. I will allow him to take a punch for the team. No. Please make a pass. Like that. You're a catcher and you're a receiver. Nice. Good. I made a touchdown! Equalized! Good. He's so ugly. Those are not. Even though they very well synchronized. Definitely synchronized. They won't be coming back. He will be coming back. So lucky. So lucky it is. Oh, it was even better for that. Alright. I should put my guys in defense. I guess this is as solid as I can get it. I have a blocker. Well, you should probably switch places. Like that. Confirm setup. Now, my plan is to don't let them score. Yes, continue punching rat face in. And when enough rat face is punched in, there will be an opening. Their entire field is an opening right now. If I can just punch a little tiny bit, punch them to pieces, I should be able to take the lead. For the first time in Gaben's Gulle-Grabbar's history, I will be in the lead in that case. This is a game where things just started working. Things were looking really poor, but then I killed a guy and injured another, and things started looking well again. I even have both my rerolls this half. I think this is a match I will win. And now I have jinxed it, and I will suffer terrible losses at the hands of my foe. Alright, let's put the ball right in the middle. Hopefully it won't scatter too much. They must move one square. That doesn't help him very much. I could put guys around my center, but that just puts more tackle zones on his guys. Then I will just have them stand there while I move around. Oh, I hate bad puns. Who can hate bad puns? They like best puns. He will probably have the ball from the beginning then. Yes. So. This is... Oh yes, I'm defending. He will be punching me in the face. That's right. I was still thinking offense there. In which case my setup would be really sucky. He will then continue punch face to break through. Fortunately, I still have tackle zones all over. Here we go. And he's starting to tackle with his lowness. It's good for me, because if he fails, his rerolls are at a risk, as just happened. So far it's working well though. That's not good. My guy is just stunned. It seems Skallen took a beating to his head. Now, you see the little mark down right there on Sinidan's play card? That means he's a star player. Well, that was expected. He'll probably put more of my inexperienced guys up front. I had two guys with experience there. Two experience would be lost if they were knocked down, while Ole Gunnar has nothing. And, well, the rest of the players do have stuff. And here comes a blitz from a guy with a block. With a two die. Fortunately, my guy will be standing. Because he also has block. Yes, move into range. Allow me to wipe you. If I were him, I would... that's a backup. But anyway, if I were him, I would try to not get as many of my rats as possible into range. He should probably go move. Yes, exactly. Move first and then pass. He wants experience from his thrower. And a fumble. So he uses a reroll for that. That's great either way. Of course, saved him one experience and the ball. And as long as a gut runner has a ball, things are bad. One, two. Well, no. His guy. But that means I can stand my guy up and immediately have a tackle zone on him, which is good. Ah, he's trying to move. I still stand him up. But he got the ball over there. And now I am really confused on what's happening. Get me guys up. And I'm really gutsy. I have a two die block against that. It's like super nice. Well, it's a two die block. Yes, take it. And it didn't work. Just block. And then I take my another chance. Like that. And now defender down. Let's see what's happening. Follow. Into the mess. And the ball is loose. So I should probably get guys over here. To stop them from securing the ball. Like that. This is my receiver. Probably mark this guy like that. And that's going for it. It's not what I had in mind. And you can just go there. And then I should probably start throwing down some blocks. One die. This guy is the assist master. If I stand him there, it will not help. If I stand him anywhere, he can just get the ball and run over there. Let's put this guy here. And put this guy here. And then try to move this guy away. Nothing happened. Block, block. So, that was it. The ball is knocked down. He's outnumbered. All his guys are in tackle zones and in base. They are based and in tackle zones. Things are looking pretty good. This guy is in a rough spot though. Bear Crump will probably get a savage beat. And the gutter runners will pick up the ball. I hate those nasty rats. grouping me together. That way he'll be able to assist. Yes, will he blitz? No, what will he do? He's just putting tackle zones on me. Assists and tackle zones. That's his little rat. That rat will not throw a tackle. That guy will. It worked fine. I will not be picking up the ball with that guy, that's one thing for sure. What's my armor value of my guy there? 8. Still has good armor value, he's just not that strong. Now, he dodges and he picks up the ball and he fumbles. That's good for me. That's his last reroll. He gets it. And now he has free reign. He could probably move around. No, he cannot move around. It's me. No. He's throwing to him. And he stumbles. And I fumbles. And the ball is down. And my guys are out. So, no, I'll probably need to get guys up. I have tackle zones on him. Get this guy here. It's just one die block. That's many die block. Many die block. That's not with a blocker. It's definitely good. Could just walk in and get him like that. There's a guy with dodge hand block. Could go like that. Like that. Go for it.
Do it! You can do it!
I'm going to reroll that one. That and follow. Get that guy away from the ball. Now I can get this guy over there. Push him. Unfortunately, I didn't get him away from the ball. I'm going to stay. Go throw this tackle. Not good. I will follow. Just one block, two die. Well, hurt them. Nice. Just punch the rat faces. No, don't do that. There. And you will probably have to fight here then. Like that. And that sucked, because then I'm pushing him close to the ball. Probably I can do this. Nope, not good. Not good. How can it not be good? Well, I'd rather have my guy standing, actually. Over there. He made it. So. That's what I wanted. I want to put another tackle zone onto the ball. Not all these guys are based. But I have 1, 2, 3 guys that are basing the ball. Is he blitzing my guy? Yes, he's going. No? Yes, he is. He's going to push him into the ball. Oh, that sucked. I'm really unfortunate if it goes to one of the gutter runners. Goes to one of my guys and goes into the square, which I have covered with almost the entirety of my team. That's good. He has no more blitzes. That didn't work out. Probably put him up there. It seems like I'm playing it safe for now. I don't want him to take the lead here. I don't know if it was right or wrong. The ball is definitely covered. The good thing is I have lots of blitzes. All my blitzes incoming. Oh, he got away, the bastard. And then he went over there, so they can assist there. Just a push. That's not just. Push is pretty good right now. Will they be able to pick up the ball? Sucked for him. Punched him in the face.
Excellent! My guy has block and everything!
Don't pick up the ball. He went for it and he's so lucky right now, and if he makes a long pass, I'm definitely in a poor spot. I'm in such a mega poor spot if he makes that pass. He doesn't. He tries to dodge out. He should have failed a dodge by now. That was like 100 rolls. Hopefully I can put beating to his guy over there. Now he's at advantage. My entire team is misplaced. Which is probably the reason why I should have went straight down here instead. He's going for it. Come on, fail a roll, fail a roll. Yes! They rolled a one! Indeed they did. Alright, let's get my catcher over here. Like that. Let's stand this guy up. Get him there. And then put him. Well, that didn't work. That works. Like that. All the way. Just two blocks, but that's good enough. And stay. Yes, I'm going to move over here, and hopefully that's going to be enough. Now, do I have any more moves to do make? Well, I can defend more from this, from that way. And I don't really need this guy as a loner, but if I just want experience, if I can knock him down. Well, I did knock him down, I did. And I knocked him out! Unfortunately, I didn't get what I wanted. I wanted the injury roll, not I got. Now, it's his second to last turn. He needs to get up and tackle my guy. Otherwise, he's not going to be able to make it. This guy could probably run all the way. He has to make two go for it rolls. I wish I had a guy to defend the left flank of my ball carrier, but I don't. Let's see what's happening now. The 2-1 grind is almost in effect, and then I just have to defend against the turn, one turn touchdown. That's his best chance. Going for it, tackling a blitzer. Hopefully he fails. He did. Good. Taking no chances. Getting 3 experience for that guy. It's a touchdown! My Roy Mean! Yay! I can't believe it! Still had the best odds there. It's definitely hard to win a I don't even know if he's able to do a one turn score now. Let's see. He wants to push guys around. I probably just want to put linemen. Same experiences. Experience. 5 experience. Well, that's the guys. No. Just get them all back. I can't have him make. I can't have him do one turn touchdowns on me. You're standing so wrong, my friend. You're still standing wrong. You suck. Bex, you suck. I know I cannot have more than 2 players in the wide zone, but I get this guy over here. So, wish me luck. Confirm so. So, let's see what happens here. He's probably going to do his best to kick my guys into smithereen. Then he should go after Ronaldo, the feigning injury champion. Or the feigned injury champion, I would say. Grammar is important to get up to Gaben's Gulle-Grabbar. That and punts. Those are the most potent. Impotent. Yes, that was an important pun. It comes for free. The next will be charged.
He probably just, yes. I'm not even sure if he's able to be. He has what it takes to chain push my guys. He decided he won his guy. Could he chain push his guy somehow? Got around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have no idea if he could do that. Put them all there. See what's happening. Well, at least I get another reroll to try. Here comes the blocks. And it's a good result for him. Smack. Not an injury. Good. No injuries and no deaths. That's what we're going for. No injuries, no deaths. No injuries, no deaths. Poof. Sweet. Smacking my guy. Is he fouling him as well? Could be fouling him. He's losing a very close game. That means he can definitely want to foul. It's not an asshole move to try to injure my guys while losing. This is Blood Bowl after all. It's all about injuring guys. He's going for the belly experience. Or the more sure experience, picking up the ball and then shooting it to one of his guys. Not one of the loners, yes, one of the gutter runners. He made it! So we got 1 experience. And now we should probably move guys into position and blitz. Or is he still... No, he's not still going to do that, but he's going to try to knock my guy down. Being able to knock him down as well, because he got block on that guy. My guy goes down. But I hope he doesn't have what it takes to move all the way over there. He should probably move his guy there. I thought he should... No, he's going to foul. He's going to foul. Yes, that's what's going to happen. Yes. And he got a stun. And the game was already over. I try to say good game, at least. So, that's what it. I finally won a match in this league, and I did it by killing Skaven and then scoring some touchdowns. Excellent. And my winnings was definitely maxed out, and I had no injuries, so I'm definitely back in this game now. Definitely back into this game. I have a fan factor. I have a fan. And with that, I'm going to say goodbye and see you for next game.